Good morning, afternoon, evening, night. Sandra Crathern, Inner Vision Health and Wellbeing Tips for the Week. My 7th millionth vlog. Exaggeration. But so this week, I'm so excited. I am starting this 6-week course on positive intelligence. And it's all about, I've always talked about emotional intelligence, you know, how we manage our emotions is very, very high. Nowadays, people are much more aware of having a higher emotional intelligence than a IQ, which is the academic intelligence. That's great to have a great, you know, brain function, but actually our emotional intelligence is really important. And now we're coming to another level, I've noticed, of positive intelligence. So what is that? Well, it's a really about measuring the percentage of time that your mind operates in a calm, creative, positive mood, you know, empathetic, curious, and so on. So that the more calmer, productive, happier ways of being rather than the negative being. And this PQ, positive intelligence, is really about harnessing ways and methods of how to shift more into the positive mindset rather than the negative. And I mean, the neuroscience behind it is incredible. It's about the neural pathways that we almost constantly go down and create like a trough almost that our brains go. As soon as we go down a negative road, it sort of goes down a certain path constantly. And what positive intelligence does is it helps to train us to shift from that negative, which is draining and unproductive really, when we're constantly negative or depressed or down or you know, it can be very draining and it's unproductive. Not that we don't need to recognise when we're not in an uncomfortable place, but it's what we do with that information over a period of time rather than stay in those grooves of negativity about how we can shift. So this 6-week course I'm on, I'm really excited because I think it will help me, because I'd really like to be operating at my peak. You know, obviously some days it's going to be better than others, but I really would like to shift that more and more in myself. And if I can learn some of these tips, which I'd like to pass on to you over the next few weeks, then anything's worth a try, isn't it? If it makes me feel happier and healthier, become more creative and productive rather than go down negative roads. I mean, I've already started doing going in a cold pod in the morning, because I notice in the morning I can be a bit like doom and gloom for no real apparent reason. I haven't even got out of bed really. So going in that cold pod for me sort of shocks my system and helps me to adjust my mental thought into something more positive. So that's already a start. And I'm aware that on the course we talk a lot about breath work and being in the present moment. So I'm really hoping to share some of these tips with you. So just for today, I would say be more present and more mindful, because there is research to suggest that all the pain is in our story of past events or future events, things that we can't control that have happened in the past, or things in the future that we can't control either. So just today's tip will be just to be really present, very regularly check in, take a few nice deep breaths and feel grounded and notice how that makes you feel. So yes, I'm going to be really embarking on my course later on this evening, and I'll feed back more information. But yeah, positive intelligence is the way forward.